All right, guys, gals, non-binary pals, we got one of the newest G.I. Joe classifieds here, one I was super excited for, Metalhead. I did have a Metalhead when I was younger, so I was super excited for this new one, because Metalhead's always been one of those, I don't know, this round of characters, there's some weird ones, you know, Big Boa, Metalhead, there's some, you know, odd little characters in here, and Metalhead was definitely an odd character. Anyone who walks around with missile launchers strapped to each of his limbs is something's wrong in their head, which was always funny about Metalhead, because, you know, one stray bullet and you're done. One stray bullet hits one of those missiles on your thigh, man, you're done. So this is based on his version 1 from series 9 in 1990. I actually did have it as a kid. I don't have it anymore. I wish I had it to compare the two. Doing the research for this episode too, I sort of figured out that series 8, 9, and 10 of G.I. Joe, I had a lot of figures in that series. So I think I, you know, like most kids, I got in and out of stuff as I was a kid. And it looks like I was really into G.I. Joe around series 7, 8, 9, Alley Vipers in that series, and a bunch of other sort of fan favorites of mine are in those series. And Metalhead was definitely one of my favorites because he was so goofy. And he was in the cartoon in the comic book. He was in the comic book in a few issues, but he wasn't in the cartoon until the Deke series. So he wasn't in the original series, but when Deke took over the series, yes, Deke, that's the way it's pronounced, he was in there. And again, he was definitely a pretty wild character. Like, they made him a little crazy. All he cared about was explosions, okay? Explosions, that's it. He has a one-track mind. He's got tunnel visions. He likes to see things go boom. His first appearance in the comic book is issue 114, where it actually introduces him right on the cover as a member of Destro's Iron Grenaders, which fits in his color scheme back then, and they do keep a relative same color scheme here for this one. And obviously you can see on the box, Iron Grenaders right there. And the Iron Grenaders were my favorite G.I. Joe growing up, the Gold Helmet Destro. I loved the Gold Helmet Destro with the half red cape. So I got this in the mail from Amazon, link is below, but I have seen this on the shelf at Target. So he is out there in the wild. All right, and obviously this is a deluxe figure. There's two levels of deluxe figures sometimes with G.I. Joe. And this is, you know, one of the medium deluxe figures. It's not quite a scrap iron or anything like that, but it's like a medium deluxe figure. But obviously windowed packaging is back. It still has the art in front. The new G.I. Joe boxes don't feature art anymore, which I hate, but it's the world we live in now. They're trying to save money. You can see obviously all the accessories in there. It comes with a ton of accessories, Iron Grenaders, like I said, Cobra, Metalhead down there, the artwork, and he looks pretty cool in there. And I'm very interested in that helmet right there. He's number 118 in the series, QR code for the store, all the icons. On the other side, you got the 118 again and the art, the same art that's on the front. Back of the box has a cool, pretty darn cool action shot right there. And if you actually look in it real good, you can see a dreadnought back there, a little dreadnought back there. Some renders right there of different, you know, accent pieces. This picture makes it look really close to the old figure for sure. So I can't wait to get him out and actually put him together. It's definitely a homage to that figure for sure. A modernization, but everything is a hallmark of the original figure. If you know G.I. Joe and you look at this guy, you know who it is, you know it's Metalhead. All right, his icons, Siegecraft, Launcher, Anti-Armor, and then Computer Technology, I think is what it is. I guess for the, you know, targeting computer on his mask right there. I don't know, I had him when I was younger, I'm super hyped for this. So let's get him out, and I got a bunch more G.I. Joes to open after him. Right, Metalhead is here, and remember, he is a semi-deluxe figure, right? And so there's a lot of new sculpt work here. I don't see a lot of reuse here. I'm a little out of the loop on G.I. Joe. I don't have everything nowadays, so I don't know if everything's completely new, but most of the sculpt work and everything looks pretty new. And so if you compare this to the original figure, his original version, the color scheme is basically the same. The red on the original figure is definitely a bright red, and this gray is like a really, really light gray. It's almost white, but then the black matches too. So I like this color scheme. I like the updates to this, making it look, it's just a little duller, a little more muted. It's not as bright and colorful, which makes sense with the realism that they're trying to do with the series is what I'm getting at, I guess. And I really, really like this vest right here. He's got a mini sort of explosives vest. The original figure, his original appearance, it was just basically straps to hold the rockets on his back. But this is almost like a ballistics vest a little bit. So obviously, you know, he's got to be an explosive expert too. Maybe not, you know, tripwire or anything like that, but got that on there. It's got a little guard right here, which is really good. So the sculpt work on it is really good. It's got some paint accents on it too. You can see some, you know, some silver a sheen on here, like it's worn down on the corners. It's seen a little battle damage right there. He does have a knife holder right here. He does come with a knife. So it's good to have that on him. So I'm pretty sure he could fit everything on his body. We'll see in a second. So let's start with the head. And I almost always, don't remind me about Falcon, almost always love the head sculpts in G.I. Joe. And this definitely, this is a good one right here too. Because it looks different than everybody else. Like it gives him so much personality right here. Like he's got his, you know, signature goatee, his flowing locks right here, which actually come off. He actually has an alternate hair, which we'll see in a second. So his hair is removable. And I even like the windswept look to the hair a little bit, you know, because obviously he's shooting rockets. There's explosions going on. So obviously, you know, there's whoosh, there's explosions brushing his hair back. So I definitely dig this. This is a great update to the original figure for sure. I love the stylings. I love the stylings on this. If you turn him around to the back, he's got this really cool, it's almost like a Dead Space-ish Isaac from Dead Space. But obviously this is the harness that holds the, you know, the big rocket launcher when we get it on the back right here. But it looks really good. It's definitely futuristic, you know, pretty futuristic. But, you know, he's got rocket launchers on his back. Come on. He does have, obviously he has these pegs on the legs, right? Right? Instead of having pegs on the rocket launcher and holes on the legs, they went with pegs on the legs to go into the rocket launchers with the holes. So we'll get them on in a minute too when we look at the accessories. They are pointed forward a little bit. They're at an angle, diagonal a little bit, pointed forward. So we'll see what it looks like when it gets the thing on. It looks like it's an extra piece on here, but it is pretty firm on there. Like maybe it's glued on there, but it is an extra piece, an outside piece. And I always like those in G.I. Joe's as long as they look pretty good. And his vest looks amazing. And I think these look really good too. He's got a really good texture to his pants right here. Good colors on the boot and everything. Some cool details on the shoulder right there. Mr. Destro. I hope this means that Gold Helmet Destro's coming soon with a cloth cape, with a cloth cape. Come on, do it, G.I. Joe. You can do it. And the vest hides it pretty well, but he does have an ab crunch in there. So I don't really go over G.I. Joe articulation fully in these videos because I've done 100 of these by now. If you do tune into my channel and I'm one of your G.I. Joe people you like to watch, first of all, thank you so much. Second of all, I don't go over it every single video because it's all about the same. He does have butterfly joints there. He's got the basic G.I. Joe movement, double elbows, double knees. There's no surprises there. The hand is forward and backwards. There's not a lot of leg movement here because he's got thick thighs and this extra piece right there. So he can't get his leg up too much like that. But the movement everywhere else is perfect. It's perfect G.I. Joe articulation, perfect G.I. Joe movement. The head moves really good, even with the hair in the back right there. He does have an ab crunch. Obviously, you can't see it from the front. If you look at it from the back, you can see it a little bit. But from the front, you can't see it at all. But it is there, and there is a swivel there too. So his articulation is ballin'. This look is ballin'. I really like the color scheme too. That's ballin' too. So let's check out, first things first, let's check out his head accessories. So we'll look at his alternate hair. His alternate, it's not really a mullet, is it? No, it's not a mullet. So the cool thing about his other hair is it's got the goggles instead of being a separate piece because he puts it under his hair. His original figure had the goggles permanently on his face and the helmet was separately. But the way they did this is they put the goggles sort of attached to the hair. So let's get it on there. And there you go. It looks pretty good. I think that looks pretty good. This is how I'm going to display him for sure, because that's how I remember him. The original figure, he had that targeting computer goggles, yellow goggles sort of stuck on his face, you know what I mean? They look a little big, I guess, a little off-center, and you can't adjust that at all, right? Because the hair can only go in these slots right there, so there's no way to adjust that a little bit, but, you know, I think it's good. I'm going to keep it on there. That is Metalhead. Metalhead, from my memory, that is him. But he also does come with that helmet, right? So we could check out that helmet too. There's that helmet right there. It almost looks like a I don't know, like an old style gladiator helmet or something, you know? But if you get it down at the right angle, it definitely looks better. It looks kind of goofy up like that. But if you actually put the eyes over his eyes, oh man, I actually like that quite a lot. That looks pretty cool. I think I'll display him with the visor to me, but I don't necessarily dislike this look. This look is definitely for somebody. He's definitely pretty hardcore, pretty metal with this on. It does have good sculpt work on here. It's got some paint details, some silver around the edge. You know, the big yellow eyes on there too. Like, it definitely looks pretty cool. This is definitely for somebody. And so the first accessory we'll look at is just a knife, because there's nothing really to look at. It's just a small, you know, normal knife, goes right in that holder right there. Bam. So he's got his knife. Again, that was just a sculpted detail on the original figure. But just like Classified does, it's a knife in a holder. All right, next thing up are these are the thigh rocket launchers. So obviously they have a hole right there to put that peg into, just like that. And they have two rockets each. And this is just like the original figure. He had those light gray holders with the yellow rockets that just poked out on his thighs. So we'll get these on there. All right, well, that one went on really easy. This one did not go on super easy, but they're definitely on there. And obviously, the peg is not just a peg, it's a ball joint. So you can actually spin this in different directions, because obviously he's using this computer to target. So this is probably computerized, right? You know, he looks to the left, it automatically swings to the left. He doesn't, you know, manually move it with his hand or anything crazy like that. That's how the thigh launchers look. They have good sculpt work on them. They have, you know, that bright silver accent on them too, to give it a little contrast, which looks really good. And it definitely looks right in place on his thighs. Obviously, you know, there's a goofy, unrealistic character to have rocket launchers on your thighs, but it definitely looks good. It looks like it works to me. All right, next thing is his back rocket launcher. There's obviously ball joints there. As you can see, I could spin it all around. And there's a swivel right there and a hinge. So you can move this in all sort of different directions. It did pop right out there, but pops right back in. There's no fuss, no muss. So this looks pretty good. Obviously, this is going to peek over his, you know, shoulders while he's in the back. And you can see the ball joint right there. But the sculpt details are awesome. You can see the inlay right here actually matches his back, the back armor that I showed off already, that one right there. You can definitely see that it lines up pretty good right there. Flip it around to the back. It's got a little more sculpt details. There's no paint details. The only paint details are right there. Wish it had a little more paint details, but sculpt work looks really good. I'm very impressed with that. It does have these two hoses right here. Even the original figure had black hoses that went down to, you know, his leg cannons. So we'll obviously get this on his back. It does have a backpack hole, and it also has two more holes, maybe to give it more stability, because, you know, G.I. Joe backpacks are not very stable, which I've talked about quite a lot before. But no, it doesn't. It doesn't stay in there very well. So, but it's there. Let's hope it stays in there. And that's what he looks like with them sort of peeking over his shoulder right here. But like I showed you, they're fully articulated, right? He can look over there and, you know, launch that direction. Switch back to that direction too. So this looks really, really good. I dig it. When I was doing these, there was no place to put the hose, but it's on the front. There is a hole right there in the middle of the front, which is actually the back. So swip it around to the back. The silver goes on the back. All right, and that's him with all his launchers on him. His launchers on him. And man, does he fit the aesthetic that you think he would fit. I think this looks pretty darn amazing. I hope the backpack will stay in. Once we get the missiles in there, they're going to look even cooler. He does have a couple guns too, which we'll check out in a second. But I'm very, very happy with how this looks. This looks awesome. I love the posability of the launchers too. How they have, you know, a swivel there, an arm there, a ball joint up top. So you can get all these crazy different directions, you know, if you're shooting that way or whatnot. These do keep popping off, but, you know, it is what it is.
All right, and he does come with two guns. The original figure, I believe, just had a small gray pistol. So this is definitely an upgrade from them. This is an automatic rifle of some sort. And this is, I've seen this gun somewhere before. I forget where. This is definitely reuse right here. But they do have the paint accents. So he's got the same sort of paint job as him. And they're pretty cool. Sculpt work looks good. Paint job looks good. He's got one for each hand. Not that he needs them. He's got freaking rocket launchers all over his body. He's got the launchers. Obviously, he needs something to launch. He's got the missiles, too. So the original figure had six missiles also. They were all just plain bright yellow. And they were all the same. Here, there's two different sizes, right? So these small four ones are the same size. These two bigger ones are obviously for the shoulders. And then they have blast effects, too. So they all have blast effects. So you could put them, I'll check in a second, but I think you could put them in the holsters with the blast effects, without the blast effects, however you want to display it. The cool thing about the blast effects is they are removable, right? It's just a peg at the bottom. So yes, you can put it in just the missile in the launchers, which I'll mess with in a second, or you could put the blast effects in there. I don't know if these are all new. I don't have the Steel Corp set or scrap iron, so these could be reused from that, but they do have this big peg at the end that fit into his launcher. So these might be new just for him. Let me know in the comments below, just so I know if they're new or not. Inform me, teach me, but they definitely look cool. I love how the paint job fades from, you know, white to sort of that translucent orange as it gets nearer to the rocket. They look pretty cool. It's the same color roughly as the original figure, yellow, but you know, it's muted a little bit, just like the rest of his colors. All right, so a couple of corrections, messing with the missiles, right? So everything goes in with blast effects, obviously. The big ones up here with the blast effect attached, small ones down here with the blast effect attached. The small ones will even fit in there. They're a little loose with no blast effects if you just want to put them in there, like they're sitting there. However, the big one does not fit in here without blast effects. So you have to use blast effects for the top ones. You don't have to use the blast effects for these ones. Does that make sense?
So it's really a bizarre choice, a completely bizarre choice that you can't put the rockets in there without the blast effects. I don't understand that.
So, I mean, once you get the blast effects on there, this looks really good. I mean, I think it looks really good without them too, obviously, but these just ratchet it up just another notch. It looks really good. I'm super impressed with this figure. I definitely think it was worth it. Like, this is classic Metalhead updated to how he should be updated. I like the sculpt work, like all the blast effects. Look at that. Pew, pew, getting out of there. You can even do them separately, right? If you want to do, you know, one blast effect, one non-blast effect. Like, you're shooting them out separately. So that's him. All missiles, all blast effects, all weapons and everything. And I think this is probably one of my favorite figures that's come out relatively recently. I do have nostalgia for him. So, I mean, part of it is nostalgia talking. But I really like the job they did, and I don't see any or much reuse here. There might be reuse on the legs and stuff like that. Minor stuff, but this is a pretty cool addition to the G.I. Joe Classified line for sure. All right, so that is Metalhead, the newest G.I. Joe Classified Deluxe figure in the line, number 118. Can't believe we're up that high, but he's definitely a fan favorite of mine. I had him when I was a kid. I love this update. I do love the color scheme, and he looks exactly like Metalhead should look, a modern Metalhead, in my opinion. There's really nothing I would change about this figure, maybe a little more paint accents or something, but that's just nitpicky. Like, I really like the missiles, the blast effects, the color scheme, the new equipment, everything. And man, Classified is firing on all cylinders right now. They're releasing some really, really good figures. And I so dig this Metalhead, so dig it. So guys, gals, non-binary pals, thanks for tuning in to another video. Thanks for the support. That's all I need right now is some support, some motivation to keep going. So
Peace out. Let me know what you think about Metalhead down below. So look, so I have this Python Patrol Trouble Bubble. I have these next ones to do. This is another video right here. I'm so backed up. Vipra, Helix, and Shooter are all going to be on a video too. And I have even more. I got Techno Viper. Techno Viper came in too. So I have Techno Viper, the new series. So I'll do a separate video for Techno Viper. And then I still have one more mass unboxing to do too. Right here, Crimson Bat, Python Patrol Officer, Recondo, and Bazooka. Bazooka right there. So I still have a lot of G.I. Joes to open.